Hello! The most common request I get from you guys is a list of beginner-friendly open source repositories to contribute to on GitHub. So today I'm gonna show you four of them, and the number one is Zelt. This tool allows you to create rules for validation, and you can apply them on objects coming from a server or, for example, on form inputs. The README shows a very basic usage that is in fact all you need to know to use the library, as all other methods are explained right after. If you want to contribute to this project, just head over contributing.md and you can find that it uses Yarn as package manager and Jest for automated testing. Code coverage is around 93%, so before submitting new code, make sure it is properly tested. The programming language is TypeScript and pretty much everything is in this types.ts file. Here, you can find all supported types with the respective helper functions to define the validation rules. For example, let's say you have a date field that must be after a given day. You can use the min check. When the date is parsed, if it's before that day, it will fail the validation. By the way, here it says that I implemented this feature in a pull request 4 months ago. I really like this library and I also use it in production. If you want to find a cool project to contribute to, Zod might be a wise choice. Okay, so next up in the list, we have Link-Free. As you might guess from the name and also the repo description, it's an open source alternative to Linktree, the popular platform that lets you create a page with all your social links. The used language here is JavaScript, and the main README already has a lot of information describing the project, how you can install it, run the tests, contributing and even using the project by adding your profile links. The issue tab is really well managed. Labels are efficiently used to categorize the issues, which is a huge help in finding the right one for you to contribute. The project is maintained by the EdiHub community, an inclusive group focused on open source as a way to learn, work with different people, and network. You should definitely check them out. Speaking of promoting open source, you should subscribe to my channel. And here's why. My name is Leonardo and I talk about open source. I'm a web developer and I use VS Code. So these are the three main topics you will find on my channel. So you better subscribe if you're interested. And back to our list. The project number 3 is DateFNS, which I guess stands for functions, I don't know. Anyway, this project is a date manipulation library written in TypeScript, and it works pretty much like Lodash, but for dates. This means you have at your disposal a couple hundreds of utility methods to parse, convert, and work with dates in general. As you might know, dealing with dates is always such a pain, so libraries like DateFNS are so beneficial to the ecosystem. All the information you need to contribute to this project, guess where, is in contributing.md, starting from the kind request of using TypeScript. This is because the library used to be in plain JavaScript, but the team decided to migrate over TypeScript, and they see this as a great improvement. Similarly to Zod, the DateFNS codebase is deeply tested as well, and coverage is around 98%. So if you're thinking about contributing to this project, don't forget to also write some tests. Full documentation of the library can be found at datefns.org, where you will also find a list of all available functions. Before talking about project number 4, let me remind you that I just launched a Discord community. If you want to join, the invite link is in the description. See you there! Okay, back to our list. Project number 4 is not really beginner friendly, but it's Visual Studio Code. It might be difficult at first to get into the project, but if you click here, I recorded a 7-minute video where I explain you how to step by step get to know the code base and get familiar with it, and you will find yourself contributing real quick. In any case, the project is mostly written in TypeScript and there's a lot of documentation to make the journey to your contribution as smooth as possible. For example, this page shows the project structure. Anyway, the video where I talk about all the process to get your pull request accepted by the Microsoft team is in the description. You can check it out. So, to wrap up, if this list was not enough for you, and you want to know the secret recipe to find your perfect open source project, well, this video is exactly what you're looking for. Before clicking, let me know in the comments if you like this video where I showed you a list, because if you're interested, I can tell you about more projects. And leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and that's everything. See you in the other video.